Roger. So, with a friend, we one time had a pirate radio station. And that's a story for another day.
Did you go to Seton Hall Pirate Radio?
What was that about Seton Hall?
Isn't that what their radio station is, Seton Hall Pirate Radio Station?
No, Seton Hall is a legitimate university radio station.
No, I know that, because I think that's what they call themselves, don't they?
Oh, I don't know. I haven't been listening to them in a long while.
WSOG? What about a mobile pirate television station?
I haven't heard of that one. Check this out.
cheaper. A nonprofit is under $1,000 a year for the licensing.
It's really gonna be cheaper, right?
Well, it's a, so you could be nonprofit, I think, on shortwave, but you know, I don't know where you. I'd have to talk to him again about that. I'd mentioned FM to him, and they told me at the office what will happen if I buy a transmitter, and I contact them, and I'm setting up the payment for the fee. They're going to come out, and they're going to drive around, and they're going to look at my antenna, because I'm not allowed to have a directional antenna for that broadcast. And only a certain amount of wattage if it's non-profit. So they'll drive around, and if they get a complaint from another station saying so-and-so is interfering with our listening audience, I'll have to do something about it. Either lower the antenna or lower the power, or find another spot on the band.
Yeah, QSL. Now my amplifier went back on. I put the radio on. I'm hearing music on 3860. I must admit, the music before the guy's playing is pretty good, but it's definitely not the place.
By the way, the commercial station goes by how much power to it, and it starts in the thousands per year.
So, if you get a if you lease your programming to Christian or religious programming, are you considered nonprofit?
You can't do that if they're advertising. You can do nonprofit. I think you could have some type of readings from religion, but you cannot organize something that pertains to money when you're nonprofit. In other words, I said, so let's say I was to broadcast, I'm having a sale. You can't do that. You have to be commercial when you mention the word sale.
Okay, so a commercial shortwave license and a commercial FM or AM license in the broadcast bands. What are the prices? In other words, would a commercial shortwave station be cheaper to be licensed by the FCC?
You mean a non-profit?
No, a profit.
Oh, no, now you're getting into money. You're getting into the mold of what the regular non-profit license would be. You see, when you're non-profit, you're asking for people to help you out, right? Like, if you were my neighbor and you were interested in it, I'd say, you know, I can't offer you much, but some free time on the radio if you want to be a host. And that's what they do with nonprofits. Versus profit, you're always trying to make money at every turn you can make. So they're aware of that. So they have a set fee, I believe. You'd have to look that up in stateside. I'm not sure how much it would be, but I'm sure it's not cheap.
I don't think it's that kind of draw that you nonprofit is commercial. We're not proud of all different classes. There's ways you can make money on the outside. There's all different variations of nonprofit.
Yeah, these guys, did you mention, Ron, you were mentioning about these guys who lease out these religious broadcasters that lease time. Like you mentioned, Al Wiener, is he considered commercial? Is he considered profit or non-profit?
Oh, he's a profitable station. That's in the hundreds of dollars per hour. Those religious programs
are for.
I don't think they're that cheap.
But he's a WBCQ. I assume that's his station.
Yeah.
It's a profit. It's a commercial shortwave.
Already. I asked them for some of their rates, and that was in the 90s, and it was in the hundreds of dollars per hour.
Hey, that's not cheap for broadcast, you know,
sorry? Well, it was. I think that I might even have quoted a half an hour because I thought it was expensive for just a solo individual like me that wanted something on the air. I remember it being in the hundreds of dollars even for a half an hour. It was like $600 an hour.
Oh, I don't know what a regular FM station would get, but I would think that it's more than that, right?
Probably. Today it's $1,000 an hour. It might run for a couple of hours, 3 hours. They might be making as much as, I don't know.
Yeah.
was off, and little that they didn't know, he only had 4 months to live, and he died shortly after that.
No, I didn't know that he died.
It's kind of ironic, because I remember hearing him. He's the old guy with the withering voice, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
That's right. Brother Stair.
He's not my favorite, though. Mine is Dr. Gene Scott. And when he was on TV, it was Sunday night. So we go back to work on Monday, and on lunch, that was always the topic, and somebody would always pipe up at lunch hour. This is the A3LG and Company. And they would say, did you hear what Gene Scott said on TV? He said, if you're at home, and I know you're watching this, and you're living at home, and you got a good job, you got a good sound vehicle, and you go to the beach with your girlfriend, and,
the story, is that the one that was struck by a storm?
I don't know what happened to it, but it's, you didn't, who the heck was in it? You know who was, I think Philip Seymour Hoffman was in it.
Is that your queen?
What?
Is that your queen?
Say again?
You said you're looking at Queen?
Yeah.
So was that, so off the ocean, was that like Coney Island, Brooklyn, right?
Yeah, I'm in Rockaway Beach, what's your handle?
Jimmy, Julia, and Mike. I grew up on North Jersey. The Rockaway Beach is like a Ramones song, right?
It's what?
The Ramones made a song about Rockaway Beach, didn't they?
Oh yeah, that's right, they did. That's because, what was the lead singer? I guess his name was Ramon. Yeah, he's from Rockaway Beach. But yeah, we're right on the Rockaway Peninsula, and a little bit further west of here is Brooklyn and the Jamaica Bay, and then you'll have the Coney Island area. Jim, what's your call sign? And let me see if I can look up that movie. It was about a pirate radio station.
That's pretty funny. The pirate commercial station. So I used to be a badass until they caught me broadcasting. Now I gotta pay.
Did you get the movie, Ron?
No. But you know, they have caught some people that were pretty big. They had no other choice.
That's right. That's what happened to this guy. He actually went commercial.
After a lot of hassle in court?
Pirate Radio.
That's it. That's the name of the movie, Pirate Radio. Thank you.
Now, they've been...
Not to correct you, but they were off the coast of England, ever.
Pirate Radio.
So pretty interesting, isn't it?
Yeah, you would like it.
What air does it take place?
What was that?
What decade does it take place?
2009.
Oh, well, it's a modern day portray, or is it supposed to be back in the day?
Oh, the movie was made in 2009, and it takes place circa in the 70s.
It's all 60s, 70s tunes. Okay, did he play music or was he propaganda?
Everything.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, people, they lived on the boat, and they were going back and forth. They were even visited by the Coast Guard and all that.
Where they get all the fuel to keep the generators going.
Yeah, he was just outside the 3 mile limit.
Is that all it is? It's 3 miles out?
That's it. That's a gray area, but I believe it's 3 to 12. Or it could be, I don't know, 3 to 12 miles, but then outside of 12 miles, you're in a different area. I think full international waters is outside of 12 miles, but I'm not 100% certain on that.
Transmission level 2.